Hi, and welcome to this section here where we are going to look at how we can integrate a function by recognizing the presence of its derivative. So the prerequisite for understanding this very well is just a basic understanding of your differentiation techniques and specifically the chain rule. Very importantly, you also need to have a sharp eye, since all we are doing here is trying to see that, hey, I think I can see a function and I can recognize its derivative. Okay, then we kind of move from the process of differentiation, and then we are able to find the solution to our whatever we are trying to integrate. So we will illustrate this by looking at a few examples here, and then these examples are picked from your resource book of your Pure Math. Specifically, this is Pure Math 2. So we can try out a few examples here, and then the rest of the problems you can go out and try on your own. If you have any problems, you can always post in the comment section. Whoever sees it first should be able to answer. I encourage everyone to, you know, get in the habit of, you know, helping others solve problems, because when you do so, you really also get better at whatever you're doing. So the very first example we'd like to look at here is how we can integrate this function here. So there are many methods of solving integrals, and one of the quickest ones you should be able to see, or you know, see whether you can use or you are not able to use, apply for that matter, is that you can see that, do I have a function and can I see its derivative somewhere? So in here, I'll illustrate this by bringing your attention to the function here, which is inside the parentheses here, 3x squared plus 2. So realize that this function here, 3x squared plus 2, if you are differentiate it, you should be able to get an expression which involves this other function which is outside the parentheses. I.e., if you differentiate 3x squared plus 2, then you have an expression which involves this x raised to the power 1. Okay? So if you are able to see that, then the procedure is as follows. That you will get the function, okay? If you think that, hey, I think I have the function and its derivative, so you get that particular function, okay? And then whatever power it is raised to, you increase that power by 1. Okay, the reason will become apparent in a few seconds. And then we differentiate that. Okay, so when we differentiate that using the techniques of differentiation, which we know that we shall drop the power, then we write whatever we have inside the parentheses, and then we drop the power. Okay, so the reason of raising this power by 1 to 5 is because in the due process of differentiating, we are going to, you know, drop back to a lower power, which is going to give us the expression which we already have here, okay, which we are trying to integrate. Okay, this expression here, 3x squared plus 2 raised to the power 4. Alright, now if we continue the process here of differentiating, of course, we drop the power, then we write whatever is inside the parentheses, and then we drop the power by 1, reduce the power by 1, and then we multiply times the derivative of whatever was inside the parentheses here. So the derivative of 3x squared plus 2 is 6x, okay? So the next step is for us to rearrange this, and then maybe 5 times 6, we have 30, and then we have the x, and then we have 3x squared plus 2, then raised to the power 4. So at this stage here, you should be able to recover whatever you were trying to integrate. So in here, we are trying to integrate, we are trying to integrate this expression here. Oh no, let me use a different highlighter, a different color. Yes, we are trying to, yes, That is it, the expression x into 3x squared plus 2 raised to the fourth power. And you realize that we have been able to recover it here, okay? X into 3x squared plus 2 raised to the fourth power. So that should give us a signal that we are moving in the right direction. So once we do that, the rest is just simple algebra because it is just now simplifying. So we can decide to divide both sides by 30. Since 30 is a constant, it can come into the derivatives, inside the derivative sign here. So we have 3x squared plus 2, then raised to the power 5 here. And then on the right hand side, we have the expression x into 3x squared plus 2, then raised to the fourth power. Now at this stage here, it's now just a matter of integrating both sides. So when integrate the right hand side, okay, and we start with the right hand side, we can say we have x, this is 3x squared plus 2, then raised to the fourth power. We integrate it with respect to x. Then once we apply the integral on the left hand side here, since these are reverse processes, the integral sign will make the derivative signs here disappear, and then we should be able to write whatever is inside there, inside the derivative sign, as 1 over 30 3x squared plus 2 then raised to the power 5. And don't forget the constant of integration. Okay, so if I haven't made a mistake, this should be it. If I have made a mistake, you can please put in the comment section and highlight it. Okay, let us look at an example, another example. So we can look at example 2 here. And we want to integrate sine squared 4x times cos of 4x. Maybe what we need to know is that if the way we are writing here, sine squared 4x, okay, it is the same as saying sine 4x then raised to the power 2. We are just writing, you know, just different ways of notation, okay? So in here again, we'll be like, we see that, hey, I think we have a sine, okay, sine for x, and we are pretty sure that if we differentiate the sine, then we should get an expression which involves cos for x. So we actually have our presence of a function and its derivative, okay? Yeah, I forgot something here. Maybe I should have said we are differentiating this with respect to x. So we have the function and then we have its derivative. So we say that the procedure is that we are going to write the function and then we raise it to another power. Let me use this notation here for purposes that I'll explain later on. So we raise it to the power above and then we differentiate this, okay? So when we differentiate it with respect to the variable x, we'll drop the power, okay? Then we have sine 4x. I think I can write the 2 now here, it's okay. Otherwise I would have put the parentheses and then I put the 2 outside, but I want to do that. And then what else? Yeah, then the derivative of whatever is inside here, which is the derivative of sine, which is cos 4x. Actually, it is 4 cos x. So I will do that, then times 4, then times cos 4x, all right? So, why I decided to put it out here and not here is because I wanted to, not here, is because I wanted to explain this process quite easily, that the chain rule, that we drop the power, then we reduce the power by 2, then again we take the derivative of whatever is inside the parentheses here, okay? Yeah, so the next is just to rearrange this. We have the constants that will give us 12. And then we have sine squared 4x, and then we have cosine 4x. Again, you realize that the expression, you realize that this expression here, okay, which you have here, is that we have been able to recover it here. It's just this, okay? So if we are at that level, then the rest again is just algebra. What are we going to do? We are going to divide both sides by 12. So we have, this is, okay, I can write this here now. Okay, I hope I'm not abusing notation by changing it from one notation to the other, but you can write that way, 1 over 12 sine to the power 3, 4x. And then what do we have on the right hand side? Sine squared 4x cos 4x, right? Then the next is that we just integrate both sides with respect to x, and then we can now start with the right hand side. We put it on the left hand side, so we have this. And then we have this with respect to x, and then if we integrate this, then we are going to get rid of those derivative signs, and then we have 1 out of 12 sine cubed 4x, and don't forget to add our constant of integration, okay? So that's it. Yeah, then maybe we can look quickly. I think we have some time for just one more example. And what is this example? We'd like to integrate x squared. Then we have the square root of x to the 3 plus 1, then times the x. Again, so we can see that we have a function here. Okay, we have a function, and then we can also see the presence of its derivative. Okay, so then the next thing is that we are going to rewrite our function, which we have, which is x cubed plus 1. It is raised to 1/2, then we add 1 power to it. That will give us 3 out of 2, and then we differentiate this. And then usual way, we drop the power, we rewrite whatever is in the parentheses, okay? And then we reduce the power by 1, and this will give us 1/2, we recover whatever we had up there, and then times the derivative of whatever is inside the parentheses here, which is 3x squared. And then on rearranging these terms here, we have 9 out of 2, and then let me put the x squared here, then we have x cubed plus 1, then to the power 1/2, okay? So we can multiply both sides by 2 out of 9, so we have 2 out of 9, we differentiate with respect to x here, and then we have x cubed plus 1 to the power 3 over 2, and then here we have x squared, x cubed plus 1 raised to the 1/2. Okay, so yes, so I think we are in a good place, because why? Because here on the right hand side we have the expression here, which is our original expression, which we had here under the integral sign. Okay, so all we need to do now is just to integrate both sides, okay? So we shall integrate both sides, which is x squared into x cubed plus 1 to the power 1/2 dx. And then we integrate also the left hand side, and then we recover the function which is inside the derivative sign. So we have 2 out of 9 into x cubed plus 1 to the power 3 out of 2 plus our constant of integration. So in summary, we have looked at how we can integrate by recognizing the presence of a function and its derivative. And then the procedure was that you get the function, you raise it to the higher power, and then you get the function, you raise it to a higher power, then you take its derivative, you get the expression, you recover the expression which you have under the integral sign, and then the rest is just like you just simplify. Okay, you simplify here, and then after simplifying, then you take the integrals on both sides, and then yes, you come up with your final answer. Okay, so you can please try out as many problems as you can. Unfortunately, we cannot look at so many examples. We try to make this video short and straight to the point. Okay, so try out as many problems. If you don't understand anything, you can always post in the comment section, and I'm sure you'll get some help. So thank you, and see you in the next video.